Hi, welcome to a new video about my Raka Cooker standalone programmer. It's a programmer based on Arduino Nano with an LCD display together with a keypad. This is a mock-up and a test version of the case and the software, and it's based on again Arduino in a 3D printed housing. Looking at the programmer, you can see there's only one connection. It's a DB9 connector connected to the 7-pole Klansman style connector used by the Raka Cooker to connect it to program it. A power plug adapter because it's battery powered, and on off switch. So when we turn on the programmer, let's try to focus. It starts up with a welcome screen, and there's a menu selection where we can select the model, and we can select the channel, do the programming, store the configured channels into memory. There are three banks of memory, one bank of 10 channels for every model, so they are stored separately, and of course the about screen. Looking at the keypad, there are of course the 9 or 10 numeric digits. There's a star sign which we will use as a decimal point. There's a pound sign which we will use as the backspace when trying to correct frequency values we have entered. There's the A, B, C, D button, where the A button moves you up one row in the menu, the B button moves you down one row in the menu, the C button is used to confirm your selection, and the D button is to go back one menu option. So let's have a look at the menu. The first menu option, you can select your model, is, as it says, is used to select the model. Model selection is used to define the boundaries of the frequencies and make sure you are programming the correct frequencies for the model. There are three models in this screen. The alpha variant of the Raka Cooker 4515, and it's the low VRF version. It's for the 4 meter band. There's the high VRF version, which is for the high part of the VHF band, and this one can be used for the 2 meter amateur frequencies. And then there's the UHF variant of this model, and there's an exclamation mark beside it because it hasn't been tested yet. Simply for the reason I don't own one of these models. It should work, but I'm not sure. So let's start by selecting the low VHF version of the Raka Cooker, and confirm it by pressing the C button. So next thing we do is select the channel menu option, and in here there are a list of all channels currently in the EEPROM of the programmer. The programmer contains an EEPROM where you can store program channels in the non-volatile memory, so it will remain there even if the unit is turned off. In here we can program the frequencies. For example, let's go to channel number 7. And let's confirm by pressing the C button, and this brings us to the properties of channel number 7. There's the RX frequency, the TX frequency, and an option to turn off the 150 Hz pilot tone, the NATO tone. This option is only available when programming the low VHF versions of the Raka Cooker. So let's change the frequency of the RX receive frequency by selecting it using the menu and pressing the C button. A cursor is appearing at the frequency part, and in here we can enter a new frequency. For example, 70437.5. And when we press C, it's confirmed. So let's do the same for the TX frequency and make a mistake to see what's happening. So there's a frequency error in here. Why is there a frequency error? Because Draco Cougar needs frequencies in a 12.5 kHz raster, and .55 kHz isn't matching that raster. So what's going to happen when we press the confirm or the C button? You will notice that the screen is flashing two times or three times, and it will refer to its previous setting. And this is because it failed, the frequency validation failed. So let's do this again, and by changing the to the correct frequency and press the C button. Now you see it's there. Changing the tone using the same C button, you can toggle between yes or no. So. And when you are done, you can press the D button to go back one step to the menu, in this case the channel list, and you will notice that the frequency has been changed here. By default, channel number 7 of the Draco Cougar is programmed to be at the frequency of 70.425 MHz. So, looking at the receiver, it's currently tuned to that frequency, and when I press the PTT button of the Draco Cougar, you will notice it has full signal reception. So let's turn this one to the frequency we want to program the channel to, in this case 70.4375 MHz. You will notice that it will receive some signal, but that's just because it's the devices are close to each other. But looking at the signal strength, you will notice that it's not full, receiving full signal strength, meaning it's off frequency. It's there, but it's not showing full frequency. So next I'm going to connect or disconnect the microphone plug and connect it to the programmer. Yes, it's a little bit tricky to do with one hand, the other hand. So now it's connected there, and let's go to the programmer, press the D button to move back to the main program of my menu option, and select the program option, and when we're going to program, you will see there's a progress bar in there, and if all goes well, it will finish with the OK message, and after a couple of seconds it will return to the main menu. So looking at the Draco Cougar, it went out of programming mode, and let's try to reconnect the microphone, and this is again hard with one to do with one hand, and have a look at the receiver, and when I now press the PTT button, it will have full strength. There it is. So back to the menu, and as we just have seen, we can program using the program option, and when we go back to the channel list, you can see it still has the frequency of channel number 7 to the changed value. So when we go to the save channel menu option, what will happen is it will store the current selected channels, the properties of all channels currently in memory, and only for the selected model. So when we press the C button, you will see it will save the channels into the EEPROM or the non-volatile memory, and after turning the program on and off, and after it has passed the boot up screen and you go to the channels, you will notice that channel number 7 still has the frequency in there after powering the programmer down and on again. So that was the part about saving the channels into the EEPROM memory. And the last menu option for now is the about screen, which is basically the same screen as when starting up. So what's next? Next is finishing the actual code. Although it's working, the code is complete, but it just needs some tidying up. So it's more presentable, so you guys can download and use it. The casing is just 3D printed. I think I will put in the STL files on my blog also, so you can print it yourself. And I will put in there some links to the parts used. What's in there? Of course, there's the LCD screen, there's the keypad, there's an Arduino Nano in there, and there's a 3.7 volt LiPo battery, a rechargeable battery with an Adafruit charger / booster, which allows me to have 5 volt for the programmer available and can charge and operate it at the same time. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.